spring to give your heart a song to sing.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel. It's your girl Noelle, and today's video is about all the finance apps you need as a creative freelancer. So a little bit about my background. I am a graphic designer. I went to school for graphic design for 4 years, and I've been on my own for 2 now. I do freelance work for branding, social media management, and I also run my own clothing brand called Noon Authentic. So I came into this game completely blind. I've been on my own for around 2 years now. Through my personal experiences and confiding in other freelancers, I have a list of tools and apps that I personally use and that help me with my finances for my business. And I thought that this could help you if you are also a freelance creative. So today we're going to be talking about invoices, contracts, taxes, and how I use each of these apps, including the pros and the cons. So the first app I want to recommend is Bonsai. The standard pricing for this app is $24 a month. This is a holistic servicing program, so you can make contracts, make invoices, send invoices, and this is all through email. You can have your own clientele list. There's a lot of things such as calculating your taxes for you, so it is a very all-inclusive app. I would say the pros of using this app is that it sends automated invoices. And guys, when I tell you, when I worked with so many different clients where everything is perfect, communication is great, work ethic is great, our meetings go well, but when it comes to money and the invoices, they may be probably the latest to reply to. With that aspect, automated invoices and payments are really crucial and critical, especially if you're on your own as a freelancer. Another pro is that you can automate charges for late penalties. This comes in handy because if you're waiting for your paycheck, you need to get paid. But you might also be in an awkward situation where you and your client have a really good relationship and it's just really awkward to send in another late penalty invoice. Bonsai in this way is helpful because it automates within the system. You just put it in and fill it out in the beginning of the contract. So it's more of the system sending your client the invoice than yourself. So that kind of takes off a lot of the burden and the pressure to be compensated for what you deserve. The last pro for this app is that it has automated and already made for you templates for your contract. This comes in handy when you are looking for specific jobs, such as brand ambassadorships, internship contracts, or making specific social media contracts. It has a lot of different types of creative contract templates for you, so it makes it a lot easier for you to come up with structures and boundaries to protect yourself in terms of business. And then moving on to the cons of this app is that it takes a larger percentage of your income. I believe using credit cards or debit cards, it takes around 3%. I personally don't like to charge my clientele for the transaction fee just because why don't I charge them for that? But anyways, I haven't been doing that. I'd rather opt for an app where there's a lower transaction fee, especially if they don't want to use credit cards. And another con is that their deposit time is pretty slow. It takes around 5 to 7 business days, and sometimes I just want to get paid. But yeah, that's pretty much it in terms of the cons of this app. Next application I want to introduce you guys to is WorkMade. This app is completely free. The only payment you need to make is when you deposit into your account. So the pros is that it's super convenient, it's really simple and easy to use, the UI is beautiful, very easy. It only takes 1% of your income compared to HelloBonsai, which would usually take 3%. The biggest thing that I used this app for was to estimate how much taxes I owed for state taxes. And when I tell you, I was so clueless coming into this freelance world, and I was like, taxes? EIN numbers? Like LLC. One thing for sure is to get your taxes straight. This is an app that my friend introduced me, and that's when I first learned that I need to pay taxes, especially being a freelancer. So make sure you prioritize and set aside extra income for taxes. Another good pro of this is that you can create invoices super easily and simple. It's super streamlined, and again, the UI is beautiful. The last point I want to make is it gives you access to developers because it's still a startup. So they have really fast communication in terms of customer service, and I even got on a Zoom call with one of them, earlier this year because there were some things that I had questions about and I was curious about, and they were so kind and really addressed all of my questions. Moving on to the cons, again, I haven't used this app in a really long time, but I do remember there was still a deposit time. There was no instant transfer. I would say maybe it was less than HelloBonsai, maybe around 3 to 5 business days, but there was no instant transaction option. Another con is that you can't make contracts on this program, which means that it's really used solely for finances and sending invoices, while other applications have contracts embedded with the program. So my closing notes for using WorkMade is that it's really simple and easy to use. It has really great UI, streamlined experience of creating an invoice. I personally come to this app when I have a one-time project with a short-term client and it doesn't require too much contracting, where I can just say, these are the deliverable products that you're getting from me, and this is how much it costs, send by this time. All right, and the next app I want to bring up is HoneyMade. This one is $9.50 a month. I believe this is the smallest paid package that you can get. I know a lot of different creative friends who are also using this app, so that's what kind of led me into this program. So jumping into the pros of this application, it takes 1.5% of your income if they use ACH, and that is something that you can control on your end before you send your invoice and contracts to your client. They also have a section where you can create contracts, just like HelloBonsai. I have personally never used it, but I have my own reasons for that, and I'll explain later in this video. I know I've been talking about how important and amazing automated invoices are, and this is the application that really takes care of everything for me. Unfortunately, it doesn't send penalty, but there's no point in sending penalty fees if you are able to automate invoices and set that up on your end, send it over to your client so that their bank account is tied to the program, and every month, every week, whatever the frequency is, you get paid on time, which is so important. And now moving on to the cons. As amazing this app is, the biggest downfall is that the deposit time is so long. It's 8 to 9 business days, so that means if their payment goes in the first of each month, you will get paid probably 2 weeks after that. Another con is that I would not say it is very UI friendly. It took me a good minute to adjust to the features and navigating through this website. I personally wish they streamlined it a little bit more like WorkMade, but just because this app is another holistic all-in-one place app, I can see why they have so many different features and things on the site, but I feel like they could have done a little better job of improving the user experience. My closing notes on using HoneyMade is that I personally use this for my larger retainer clients, meaning my clients that pay me regularly, almost like a salary, so I get paid every month. And I can be guaranteed to be paid and to pay my bills, pay my rent, sustain my life. And I purposely set up on my end before I send over the contract and the invoices to ACH so that the most this app will charge me is 1.5%. So there are options where I can give for my clients to pay either through their bank account, which is ACH, or through credit card or debit card. But if you turn off the toggle for credit cards and debit cards, the only option they have is ACH. And through that way, they're able to pay me in a way that I prefer. All right, so the very, very last app I'm gonna bring to you guys today is the Discover app. So I'm talking about the bank account. So I've already had the app on my phone, but one thing I noticed is that Discover has really reliable high yield savings account. It has a pretty competitive cashback rate. When I first opened it was at 3.8%, and last time I checked, it was at 4.3%, so it's always changing. Compared to other programs I researched, a lot of people were saying that Discover is the most reliable and has the most decent cashback, so that's what I moved forward with. So the last time I checked, it was 4.03% with no monthly payment. And this is compared to Chase, which is $5 per month, Citi, which is $4.5 a month, and Bank of America, which is $8 monthly fee. This app really doesn't have any cons, and I will just say I use this app mainly to store my taxes. I know for 1000% if I keep my taxes in my checking account, I will use it. If I just have it in another savings account that I see regularly, I know I'll be super tempted to want to just take from it. So using the Discover app where I don't have any of my checking accounts on, I'm able to put it somewhere where I don't see it regularly while it's growing for me. So by the time it's time for taxes, I have my money ready for it and I don't have to worry about taking from my checking account or my savings account to pay my yearly taxes. And taxes add up. Oh my gosh, tax rates are crazy. All right, so my overall notes on all of these apps I just brought to you guys. I just started using HoneyBooks to be paid more regularly and to guarantee my payments every month. I just wanted to completely take money and payments off the table in terms of conversations and meetings. I think there's always something about talking about money with your clients every meeting and what they owe you. I feel like the focus goes too much on what they are spending than what they are receiving. I wanted to cater my meetings and my conversations more towards how we are building their business and how we are improving their business, how I can help them reach their goals. Something about just talking about, oh, you owe me this. Did you pay my invoice? Did you get my invoice? It just makes the dynamic really tight and difficult. So HoneyBooks has really helped me take that off, take that pressure off, and just really focus on the services for my clients. So for Bonsai, I still have my subscription because I want access to contract signing. I just have random clients pop up or something for my clothing brand and I need to come up with an internship contract. But nothing financial really goes through HelloBonsai for me just because of the transaction fees. And because I'm already so dependent on HoneyBooks, I don't feel the need to also invest in myself financially into HelloBonsai. I use WorkMade for one-time things, like I mentioned earlier, for smaller projects where it doesn't require too much legal work and contracting. And I also use it to just keep up with tax rates in Georgia, so I'm prepared for the end of the year. In terms of taxes, I recommend opening a high-yield savings account, and I really recommend using Discover Bank. Even though you don't open a high-yield savings account or you're not in a situation where you're able to do so, if there's anything I leave with you this one video, is to keep up with your taxes. Set aside those taxes where it's always accessible and you won't use it. Don't make setting aside taxes more difficult than it needs to be. Just do it as an automatic thing. Whenever you get your paycheck, every time I get my monthly paycheck in my bank account, I immediately do the math. I think I always put out 18%, immediately transfer it to my Discover bank account. All right, guys, that's all I have for today. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. I hope this video was helpful in any way or any form, whether you're creative or you want to get into that lifestyle, or you're just someone who is interested in improving your financial life. I'm making another video on different platforms I use as a creative. So I'll be touching base on the Adobe Creative Suite, Squarespace, Toggle, Notion, and more. So stay tuned for that video. Make sure to subscribe and like this video, and I hope to see you guys soon. Thank you, guys.